Welcome back for the session. I hope you all can remember what we have discussed last week, that is regarding the Big Match 1983 by Yasmin Gunaratna. So last week, dear children, we have discussed the poem in detail from the beginning to the end. Right? Okay. So then you know that it is the lengthiest poem we have in our syllabus. Right? Okay. Now with all these things in your mind, we have to discuss the rest of the things regarding the poem. Right? You know, children, now we have to discuss about the themes and the techniques and questions based on the poem, right? Now, you know that big match is a very big term, which we have several kinds of meanings, right? We call it a separate term. If you can remember, the writer nuances the term. Let's discuss when it comes to the techniques part, right? Okay. Now, although the poem is named as Big Match, it mainly discusses the racial violence, right, caused during several days in the year of 1983. So there were so many reasons behind that, but we discussed for our knowledge only, the basic reason was that the killing of 13 soldiers in the Jaffna area, and while the burial of these soldiers happening during that 1983 July from 24th onwards, this kind of racial havoc occurred. Now, from the beginning to the end, now, in the first stanza, I'm just reminding you what we have discussed, dear children. In the first stanza, we saw how media acted out, sometimes in order to increase the tension during the season, during this havoc time period, and how they enlarged, or else how they fanned these flames into a fire. How it shows us how the innocent people, especially like the tourist, got tensed because of this incident happening all over the country, which is called the paradise. Right? අපි පුතේ අර න්ියවස් පේපර් හෙඩින්ග්ස් වල තිබිච්ච දේවල් දැක්කා නේද? With the very big letters. So they have just in order to attract the people towards their papers, they have just reported sometimes in an exaggerative way. Right? And then there was an expatriate, right, who has come to Sri Lanka in order to find his people, his beloved history, and the beloved people in this country. And then he goes back again to Toronto because he identifies, he realizes that the situation is not good for him at that moment. And then within the next stanza, we saw how this kind of brutal occasion or an incident occurred because of the politicians, political, and because of the wrong political identity and all, right? So that is our history. We are the people who created that kind of place, right? That kind of black stain in our history. Api mai pute, we have discussed all these things. And then again, the poet has given us just a single hint regarding the cricket match also. You know, dear children, we received this cricket match from the British Empire. So it was a gentleman's game actually. But later, gradually, that gentleman qualities were diminishing by even up to now. The gentleman qualities in the game also diminishing from the society. That is why, because at the end of this kind of big matches between the two prestigious schools, that kind of ill will and the havoc and the hatred, violence, everything happen. If it is a gentleman's game, how do such kind of things happen? එහෙම වෙන්න බෑනේ නේද? ඒ වගේම තමයි පුතේ. This ruling system also. So we received that from the British Empire, and now the good values, good things in it is diminishing by now. Right then, with these all general instances, general situation, the poet takes us into a specific situation, specific place, that is that minority, knowledgeable, educated, professional man's house. We knew that, we know that it is a man from the minority ethnic group, that is, he must be a Tamil. With that telephone conversation, we got the idea. This conversation goes on between definitely a Sinhala man, Sinhala friend of him, right? With sarcastic weaves, neither I'm taking up, stepping up my intake quite a bit. Neither may, but he never criticizes. Actually, we have to learn there. He never criticizes the prevailing condition. Right? ඇත්තරම් පුතේ ඒ ටෙලිෆෝන් කන්වර්සේෂන් එක ඇතුලේ එයා කවදක්වත් කොයිම වෙතැනකවත් පොඩි සාකස්ටික් වීව් එකක් අපිට දුන්නා but he had never gone on criticizing the prevailing conditions. But at last he understands well because he was really educated. අපි කියවන්න පුතේ that books symbolizes that education, civilization and all humanism and all, right? Enisa Vendati Pute, he had a very good understanding regarding the situation. He had a very good understanding about the position of the caller, that his friend. That is why he says there's nothing to අර අපි කියන්නේ පුතේ ඔයාට උදව් කරන්න මේ වෙලාවේ අපිට ඔයාට බෑ කියලා මම දන්නවා. Right? Within that pause, he says here, thanks by the way for ringing. There's nothing you can do to help us, but it's good to know some lines haven't yet been cut. We talked about this line also. And while those things were happening here in Colombo suburbia, it was that the same thing vice versa occurred in the northern area of the country, right? But here the problem was today අපි කතා කරේ නදන් ඒරියා එකේ අර 13 soldiers ලගේ මර්ඩර් එකට වගකිව යුතු පුද්ගලයින් සොයා දඬුවම් කළා නම් that is okay. But here these people have made the blunders. So that is basically because of the blind political arena. මේ අර අන්ධ politicians ලට වහල් වීම තමයි පුතේ උනේ. ඒකනම් කාරණේ අතරම කරන්න තිබුණේ these mobs and hooligans and rowdies they had to go to Jaffna and find out and fight out with those people who were responsible for killing of those 13 soldiers and all. But what is the use of making blunder? What is the use of killing and burning of innocent lives of these people who were living in the country, who were living in the down south areas of the country? So that is why it is mentioned as the blunder in the history. Of course, yes. And then we see that we discussed last week several incidents, several violent incidents, heartbreaking incidents given by the pietists here. අපි දැක්ක පුතේ අර අහිංසක දරුවෝ මරලා දාලා තිබුණ විදිහ නේද? If I trace back, three boys lie dying, blood on their khaki uniforms. We saw that blah, law and order is also were diminishing. People did not have any heed or pay attention about this law and order. Even the policemen were killed throughout the scenery, right? It is unbelievable in such kind of a religious country, I mean, religious. It should be given within the inverted commas. So-called religious country, whatever the religion is, it is obvious that we are religious. Lankawa kiyanne religious country ekak when in comparison to the Europeans. But within that religious country, daruvane, these violent, brutal killings, massacres were happened, right? Evage Bauddha rataka pute, neither. And we have seen that the symbol of Bodri, that innocent civilians, so they have run into such kind of innocent, such kind of religious institutions. Pute Bodri kiyala kiyanne, as majority of us know, what is the significance of Bodri related to the Buddhism? Neda daruvane. So that Bodri is that scenery under the Bodri is really inhuman and callous even, right? Api dannawane puthe Budhrajanan wahanseta sevanadunna bogasa, how sacred it is. Although you are in different kinds of religions, we all know what is the validity and the significance of this. When we become utterly helpless, whatever the religion is, we are going to seek protection from the religions. Then a minority man can because he is real utterly helpless. Right? But at the end, what has happened? He was beaten brutally and killed by the neighbors. Neighbors like I think Marum Kama Pute Eka Itat Vada Bayanaka Tatwayakne. Neither it is really brutal. I mean, itavada pavak. Sinful attack tavatti either. So then we happen to ask, where is this religion? Api hariyata agama koi agama ho adahana vada etakota oy neighbors la kiyana ita agamak tibune nadda, right? Yes, that is the violence. So we have seen throughout the poem that kind of violence occurred during the Black July season. That's why I told you it is a black mark in the history. That is the place where, that is the place which so fertile, right? That is the place which fertile that kind of 30 years of violence. You know, the LTTE militants were the people who were responsible for those killing of 13 soldiers. But this kind of brutal situation backed up them well. Mevage situation ekak daruwane egolanta loku vasiya benefit ekak una to spread hatred against the Sinhala people, right, in the Jaffna area, in the northern areas of the country. Ekama loku hetuwak ne puthe me demala menesunta me vidihe paadana peedana ella kirima e menesunta loku vasiyak una to spread that hatred. So all of these bloody decisions and all caused this kind of massacre in the country for nearly 30 years, right? Now, at last also the poet refers to a newspaper headlines, Sri Lanka burns alive. And also we discussed there, dear children, can you remember? Sri Lanka burns alive. That means here she has used the simple present tense, you know, the uses of simple present tense, that becomes a habitual action. It is eternal. It goes on doing, happening all over the country. Still, do you think that we have finished all these things? I don't think so. Right. Okay. Then shall we move on to the themes and the techniques? Right. So this is what we have discussed last day, right? If you can remember these pictures and all, right? This is the big patch fever flaring high and flash, along with the big match played by these hooligans and mobs and rowdies and all, right? This is the basic discussion in the poem Black July in 1983. And these were the newspaper reports, newspaper cuttings I have found. And you have seen all these pictures last week. That's why I'm going in a quick way, right? You can see how these mobs were celebrating their victory of doing massacres. So how ironical this is. That is the victory. Is that the victory they received? So you can see the fire at the background even. So I think this is the most unbearable picture I have seen. So they are really laughing and enjoying by harassing this innocent Tamil person. You can see it seems he's a middle-aged man even. So where is the respect of these people towards any other humans? Respect. All we discussed here, how they played upon these innocents' lives. එක ඉන්සිඩන්ට් එකක් තියෙන පුතේක මිනිස්සෙක් පාර දිගේ දුවගෙන යනවා එක ලේන් එක පැත්තකට දුවගෙන යනකොට අනේ දේනේ කවුරුත් නැහැ කියලා හුස්මක් ගන්න හැරිලා බලනකොට අනිත් පැත්තෙන් මිනිස්සු එනවා අවිය අමෝරගෙන. Now he had nowhere to run after. අන්තිමට පුච්චලා ඒ මිනිස්සයාව පුතේ පුච්චනවා ගෙන තියනවා පෙට්‍රල් දාලා ගෙන තියලා ඒ මැදවටේ ගින්නේ දැවි දැවි දුවන මනුස්සයව පුතේ කැතිපොලු අරගෙන කොටලත් දානවා. That is what the story, newspaper incident reported. You see how they played, actually, that the verb played. It's really ironically, I'm using that in an ironical way, how they have played the game. Actually, for these mobs and rowdies and all, that was a game. But what about these innocent lives? May ahinsaka minisunta. You see this, the rider also teasing with the man, teasing at the man, right? So they are just here. These people are wearing the national suit. So that is an insult for that also, I mean, right? We have seen this picture also. With this picture, we have discussed the poem last week. And this is a place where I want to just focus your attention. If you can see my cursor, these are the people who are there to protect the law and order, right? Law and order kiyana they protect karanna hitupu minissu, what they are doing, right? While such kind of brutal things are happening, while the law and order is also attacked and questioned here at this moment, these people were discussing here. And can I also focused your attention last day too? Here, this man was searching whether the people were, the Tamils were, the people were hiding inside the houses. E taramatama pute ituru vechi ekek konno ituru naave kiyala yanda na peerala peerala hama ekkawama maranna one kiyana tanai hitiye. Right, so those are the mobs and hooligans, right? So these people were robbing these things. Can you see? They are taking some kind of property outside, and they were robbing the each and every shops and houses and all. And you see the fires everywhere. Smoke is there in everywhere in the scenery, right? We discussed those things last day, and I think I want to pay attention again to this one also. Motorists were dragged from their cars. Vahanavala hitapu minissu demalana adala gatta to be stoned and beaten with sticks. Others were cut down. You see the brutality of these people? Can you see the violence of these people? With knives and axes, are they logs to cut down with the axes? Egalan logs the putte. No. Mobs of Sinhala youth rampaged through the streets, ransacking homes, yes, robbing and all, shops and offices, looting them and setting them ablaze. Aragattara passe avashya deval giniti yalat damma as they sought out members of the Tamil ethnic minority. Egalo hevve megolangwa Tamil ethnic minority people. A mob attacked a Tamil cyclist riding near Colombo's Eye Hospital. The cyclist was hauled from his bike, drenched with petrol and set alight. As he ran screaming down the street, the mob set on him again and hacked him down with jungle knives. E manussayanta maranaya kiyana ekak puthe maranaya excellence of killing, you know, where you find that the phrase or the paradox of excellence of killing, right? Penoda, that is called the excellence of killing. And this is where we have to come today regarding the themes. So the poet, as the foremost theme, she discusses nothing else but the violence caused by the communal calamity. Now, if you are given a question like this, right, the poetess Yasmin Gunaratna discusses violence caused by the communal calamity from the poem Big Match 1983. You have to give, you have to show with evidence whether it is true or not. I told you at the very first day how to organize an answer, right? Organize karanne kohomada answer ekak kiyana ekak daruwane mama ogollanta kiyala donna matakai. So if you want, and if there are several children who could not participate in that, I just can mention a little. The first introduction, that is the very first paragraph you have to write, you have to focus, right? Within the introduction, dear children, you have to address the question. You can use some kind of outside details, no worries, you can, but don't go on describing the outside details much. So it's a request of me, because when we go for marking, it's we really see that the students are beginning almost all the four questions in the paper in the same way, with the common and hackneyed line. This poem is written by this one. But they, it's not your creativity. I know that you, why don't you use your creativity in the at the very beginning? You have to get the attention of the examiner. You have to arouse the interest of the examiner within the introductory paragraph, dear children. Right? Introductory paragraph ekatthule puthe ugalan gannone attention ekara examiner ge. So you have to be creative. Actually, those creativity must be there. It is a must. So then don't abruptly start the question. You can just go on, beat the bush, but not for a long, long, lengthy way, right? Now, if you are writing an essay in your mother tongue, are you just going to give it in an abrupt way at the very first line? No, it's not so. So you can start the answer in a very creative way with using some kind of a little bit of outside details, but it's not regarding, remember dear children, it's not regarding the theme, sorry, not regarding the poem or the story. Puthe poem ekak ganawat, story ekak ganawat nevey oyala me introduction ekak gannone, but regarding the question asked. If you are asked about the violence caused by the communal calamity within the question, you have to show some evidence regarding the violence. If you are given a question like degradation of human values, so you have to start with that point, degradation of human values, right? I think you got my point. And then with that introduction, you have to discuss in a very brief manner, the question. in my point of view dear children, I'm asking මෙන්න මෙහෙමයි පුතේ මම කියන්නේ මෙන්න මේක සරලව තේරුම් ගන්න. If you are asked to give an answer within one paragraph for the question given, ඔය අහලා තියෙන ප්‍රශ්නෙට paragraph එකකින් answer එක ලියන්න දුන්නොත්, what are you going to write? You have to include all the details in a very brief manner within the paragraph. So that is meant by the introduction, right? So then you have to, there is an introduction and the last sentence is must be the conclusion. So most of the time the students forget to conclude your answer, right? And within the introduction, within the limit of the introduction and the conclusion, you can have your body paragraphs to prove your evidence. And proving in the sense, dear children, it's not just mentioning most of the quotations in the paragraphs. It's not meant by proving. So you get a quotation in one paragraph and you have to describe the things and you have to prove how does this quotation related to your question. Pute nikamma quotation ekak thila eka ogalange on words wali liyana ekak neve ne answering kiyanne proving kiyala kiyanne e quotation ekken kohomada oya api hitamu violence caused by the calamity na. How do you prove that violence with that quotation? That is what you have to write. Please understand this. You are writing something or anything regarding the poem and all. It's not related to the question at last. And even it must be in a very argumentative way, in a logical way. And there should be a nice flow and the coherence and the cohesion between the paragraphs and all, right? At least pute cheda tuna pitu deka hamara vithara yan eka chedayak pitu bhagayak vithara, it's okay. And remember, dear children, this is a game with time, right? Velawat ekka sadanak. So you have to have that kind of experience. Don't try to get the experience at the O-level exam. So you have to have this experience beforehand. You have to practice. Right. Okay. That is how you should. You have to organize an answer. So the second theme, violation of human rights and degradation of humanism and human values. So what do you mean by this degradation? Api kiyanne pute pirihima kiyala. Degradation of humanism, right? And human values. Manusakama, neda. Manusa vatinakam kiyana deva. Kohetada pute gehin tibune. So they were all violated. So you can use several incidents from the bottom. We saw that there are points like blood on their khaki uniforms, three boys lie dying. A crowd looks silently the other way. Co-humanism pute. Samane me wage religious country ekka minissu anu hospitality kiyana ekak majority ema naththam the most significant quality ekak karagattu jaatiyak vechcha Sri Lankans la. How did these crowds look the other way? Kohomada pute. So you have to talk in that argumentative way. You can raise questions even within the question, your answer, right? And there's another incident you can use. Mehemai pute mona quotation ekak gatta ogolanta puluwan nan eka ogolange vidihata ape answer question ekata galapena vidihata build up karanna. That is literature. That ability, that handling of the language ability must be with you, right? Another quotation I can remember is that with near the wheels of his smashed bicycle at the corner of duplication road, a child lies dead, right? And two policemen look the other way. Degradation of human values and humanism. Violation of human rights. Even we can take that the stout man who were kneeling, knelt down under the bow tree. Human rights to be survived in the society, right? the human right of using any kind of language they preferred by this in the society were violated, was violated at that time period. They are, this is a multi-ethnic, multi-religious, multicultural country. So people have the freedom of selecting any kind of language they use. And we know that the Sinhala and Tamil were the majority major languages we use here. So then why do these Tamil-speaking people were killed brutally? So is that the human right they have? So that kind of violations were there. අන්තිමට පුතේ මේ මිනිස්සුන්ට තිබිච්ච එකම අවිය, මේ මිනිස්සුන්ට තිබිච්ච එකම අසරණකම that Tamil speaking කියන දේ. Is was that correct? Language කියන එක මනුස්ස ජීවිත ගණනාවක් පිළිදීමට තරම්. We had seen the from the newspaper cuttings the number of deaths and the injuries occurred during those 3 or 4 days. Right? So then, violation of human rights. එකයි මං කියන්න පුතේ. You have to be very, very argumentative and you can do these things. There are a number of evidences given for these kind of things. Right. Next one. The damage caused to people and places in the country due to illogical thinking and misleading. The damage caused to people. Again, that kind of the evidences we can be used for the above theme also can be used here for this one also. අබැයි දරුවනේ question එක තේරුම් ගන්න දෙන විදිහ තේරුම් ගන්න ඕගොල්ලන් මේ මිනිසුන්ට කරපු damage එක අපිට පේනවා. And also the places in once in the poem the poetess have mentioned curled like the memories of our childhood. Yes, last part of the poem. The joys of childhood, friendships of our youth ravaged by the pieties and politics. So those places were all burnt out. So people ransacked the wealth of those people, the Tamil ones. Minisunta inda honda nattang ewa hondaida minisun. E minisunge dewal hondaida. Right? So all these damages were done because of the ethnic violence caused during that period. Right? I hope now you are able to deal with the themes of the poem. Okay, then shall we, dear children, go for the techniques? Right. These are some of the poetic devices used by the poetess. Okay, number one is nuance. Nuancing means, I told you at the very beginning of the poem, the writer nuances the term big batch. The nuance එකක් කියන්නේ slight variation එකක්. එකම word එක ඇතුලේ තියෙන different meanings කියන idea එක ගන්නත් පුළුවන්. A subtle difference or slight variation in expressing meaning is called nuance. Right? අර එකම වචනය ඇතුලේ බලන්නකො පුතේ මෙන්න මේ meanings තුනම තියෙනවා නේද? These all the three meanings are embedded with the term big match here. Right? The cricket match, of course, it's obvious. And if we just have a look on the very beginning, or as I said, for the first time, that is the cricket match we get by reading the title. Isn't that so? Api pute cricket match chekane apita oluwata enne. That is the big match between the two prestigious schools. Right. And this matchstick ekak, which is in the matchbox, gini petti athule thiyena gini koora, which we use to ignite a fire, right? That idea also, me podi deking me pute maha gindarak kaviluwe, sacrificial fire ekak kiyuwa api. So a stick of a box of matches used to ignite a fire. So that idea is also there. And violence created in Black July. That is the foremost meaning described here. That is what meant here. But the writer, in a very creative way, uses all these three meanings inside the term big match. Right. That is the summary. If I give you like this, the racial violence took place as a game. Meanings tunama putta ekak tanata gattot. The racial violence took place as a game, igniting fire using a matchstick. Me mona gindara ulawandat matchstick ekak tiyenne pe. නේද? එතකොට ඔය මැච් ස්ටික් කියන අයිඩියා එක, ෆයර් කියන අයිඩියා එක, වයලන්ස් ඉන් ද බ්ලැක් ජූලයි කියන එක, ලයික් අ ගේම්, ලයික් ක්‍රිකට් මැච් කියන දේ. මේ ඕල් දීස් ටර්ම්ස්, ඕල් දීස් මීනින්ග්ස් වර් එම්බෙඩඩ් ඉන් ද ටර්ම් බිග් මැච්. සෝ දැට්ස් වයි විත් වෙරි ස්ලයිට් වේරියේෂන්ස්, ස්ලයිට් ඩිෆරන්සස්. සෝ දැට් ඊස් අ ටෙක්නික් කෝල්ඩ් නුවන්ස්. Right, I hope you are okay with that. And then let's go to the next one. Use of metaphors, dear children. Right, you know what a metaphor is? Metaphor ka kiyanne mokadda kiyala dana. You know, I believe that you know the differences between similes and metaphors. Here, the big match as used as a metaphor, right? If we take it as a cricket match, the game is in other hands. In any case, even that big match game, and all that means the cricket game of cricket, and also this game of Black July was handled by somebody else, not those all hooligans and rowdies and mobs. Egalo neve ipute ara adrushyamana hastayak, invisible hand was there. That is the politics, right? Big match fever flaring high and fast, as same as the big cricket match fever is spreading all over the area surrounding that Black July fever. May brutal killing fever of this brutal killing of the Tamil civilians kiyana de bohoma vegen spread out una. That with that idea, big match metaphor is used in those places. Of fun of games, of course, yes, here that man, that Padmini's husband, is referring to definitely the cricket matches, right? Ogolanteva ganang nane, right? And then the fire, another metaphor I have taken here. Racial pot boils over, the match that lit this sacrificial fire. So all these images related to the metaphor of fire. These fires ring factory and hovel. When those torches come, all these signify the image of fire, or else the metaphor of fire. Meginna pute aviluni jatiwadi kinda racial burnings and the racial fire kiyanade. Actually, that sacrificial fire is used here in an ironical way, because there was no any sacrifice. What is the sacrifice? What do you mean by the sacrifice? We have discussed in the Nightingale also. Neda pute mona wala ba gannada me Tamil minissu jeevitha poosha kare, but nothing else, right? And third one, similes, skull, like old photographs in the flame. So these old photographs for the writer, for the poetess, that reminds her past, activity and the sensitive feelings are brought out here through that landmarks of, sorry, or childhood. Etanadi pute mekat ekkama kiyenawana the landmarks of childhood, ne? The mewa okkoma photographs wage ginnen ævilenawa. And the places and the buildings and shops where she used to go in and out during her childhood, everything was ravaged and burnt, and all the ashes, only remaining things is the ashes. So it's really hard painingly she has written there, curl like old photographs, that old photographs reminds her past, and it takes back her to the past memories. Now even the past memories had burnt out at this situation. So that is a simile we can find out in the poem. Number four, symbols. Here the fire, Toronto, and books use their symbols, dear children. We, as we have discussed, this fire is a symbol of hatred, why, and racial violence, hatred. Kindarakne pute eka avili gana yanakota. Although people have ignited that kind of fire of hatred, those they could not. I mean, they could not make it dead. Ekena puthe oya ginna aviluwe minisuma unata antimata e minisunta me ginna niwa ganna bare una. That fire remained for years and years. Avurudu gananawak tissema puthe oya ginnata ape minissu ahinsaka jeevitha beliyuna. Right? Although these politicians were responsible for igniting that kind of hatred fire, they themselves burnt out with that fire. E ginnemma oy kiyana deshapalaknyo davila alu vela giya puthe for years and years, so they could not make it out, right? And Toronto, you know that the many people who belong to that Tamil diaspora were there in Toronto. And this expatriate, although he comes here, egola me yame he avata pute, he understood within that situation, right? It is not fair in that situation does not in favor for me and my targets and all. So he goes back to Toronto. That is a symbol of, I mean, romantic purposes in the sense normal ordinary purposes, because the ordinary situation has been totally become upside down. So that's why this man, he goes back. And it draws contrast that the cities of Sri Lanka are not suitable for the romantic purposes. Evata dan metana sudusu neha mage ideas tika kriyaatmaka karanda mage decisions tikata. So it's not soothing. The situation is not soothing. That is what he understands, and he goes back. Books, you know, we have discussed that. It's a symbol of knowledge, humanity, and civilization. And that Padmini's husband, or this Tamil man, must be an educated professional, right? Of course, yes, that book symbolizes that. Now you see that education, right? Ironically and sarcastically, the poetess points out that the knowledge, and here you knowledge, humanity, civilization, and all have become threatened here at this kind of situation. Me hama dema puthe ithuru vela tibitcha manussakama kiyana de education ekat ekka bandichcha manussakama civilization kiyana de hadiyawa kiyana de code of ethics kiyana deval puthe fading away. Then e deval walata mul tana thibuna nan me wage situation ekak lankawa ithihase black mark ekak widihata wandenne naha ne. So they were highly cornered out, and they had to struggle for the survival, just for the survival. E survival ekak wenwen tamai puthe menissunta randenna siddha une. Ehema nathuwa e education aspect ekeng prayojanayak ganna nevey, right? So that books, that is a very powerful symbol used by the poetess here, because it's not the education prevailed at that situation. Adhyapanayak kiyana deyak nathibitcha minissune puthe meka kare, those hooligans, mobs and crowdies and all. So they were away from the education, they were away from the knowledge ekak thibana puthe blindly follow karanawa the politics and pieties api kiwwe hema. Yes, right. And number 5, alliteration. Big match fever, flaring high and fast. What is the repeated sound here? Fever, fur sound, flaring, fur, fast, fur. That this alliteration, you know, dear children, writers use different types of devices in their creations with a purpose, right? So you have to mention this that purpose also. So why does the poet here uses alliteration, fur sound alliteration here? Why? It don't you think, don't you feel that it gives the kind of idea of the fire? Putte yara ginnak kavilena enon sadde fur 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 sound ekak enawa apita. So that is why in a very creative manner she has used this. Ek a ginnak putte big match fever ekak ginnak ne, even the when it comes to the cricket match, that is also becomes a fire. Why not? At the end of ara bohoma lassanata bohoma behavioral pattern ekata in a methodical way they start the big matches at the very beginning with a very huge inauguration and all welcoming and all. But when it comes to the end of the big match, I mean the cricket matches, all the ill will, all the havoc and everything is there, right? ඒකයි පුතේ මෙතන big match fever, මෙතන big match අපි දන්නවා, she nuances the term big match. So it is the violence of the Black July and also the havoc plays at the end of the cricket matches. So then that big match fever also here, that alliteration denotes that image of fire here. That sound tells us the spreading of fire. අර පුතේ අර සාමාන්‍යයෙන් භූමියකට ගෙනිය ඇවිලෙනකොට අර සද්දෙන් නේද පට පට සද්දෙන් ගෙනිය ඇවිලෙන්නේ අර වේලිච්ච තනකොළ ඔය ගොඩක් ජාති. That kind of fire. Nobody was able to make that fire out. Right? ඒක කරගන්න බැරි වුණා. ඒකයි alliteration. මේ වගේ නිසා පුතේ ඔගලන් දැනගෙන ඉන්න ඕන. You have to have an understanding the purpose of using these kind of techniques. Right? Number six, rhetorical questions. අපි කතා කරන්නේද? Rhetorical questions කියලා කියන්නේ? Questions that are raised by the writers and the poets and all without expecting an answer, right? That is, they put those, they use those kind of rhetorical questions in their creations just to arouse curiosity and to arouse awareness and just to highlight their points. Here, who? Me? How the mama? The he questions from himself, like. එහා පැත්තෙන් අහන්න නැතුව හොඳින් ඉන්නවද? ඒක අහන්න ඕන ප්‍රශ්නයක් නෙවෙයි. But even the caller is really utterly helpless. I told you that day, out of just bond, out of just sympathy, he makes a call. අනේ පුතේ අර තිබිච්ච බැඳීම එයා මතක් කරනවානේ. අර 1958 වල වගේමයි නේද අපි කියලා, neighborsලා නේද අපි කියලා. ඒ bond එක නිසා. That caring and sharing is utterly because of the humanity he has. He makes this call. අර තමන්ගේ හදවතේ තිබිච්ච soft corner එක නිසායි පුතේ මේ කතා කරේ. එතකොට එයා අහනවා. ඔයා හොඳින්ද? Are you okay? Right? Are you fine? Who? Me? කවුද මම? That kind of tone is there. That is to emphasize the sarcastic view towards the peaceful existence of the minority. Actually, that is sarcasm is also there with the rhetorical question. How the mama may have a situation, Malagether, Kandanadar, Adanakanek Langra, giving a handful on the putte, can you? It's really sarcastic, right? That sarcasm is there in that rhetorical question, right? Number seven, visual imagery. I think you can find, right? Number of visual images are given here. Api pute, I know that also you also not aware of this kind of situation. Ogalan danne nahe ne, dakke nahe ne. Ne, the meva ke deyak nisane pute ogalan hoyanne me gana. Right, so visual imagery, where we are able to make images in our minds, we have to have it helps us to have visual clues in the mind, figures in the mind. Right, these are some of them, dear children. Don't worry, don't think that these are the only things we have. No, there are a lot. but I have taken here several points. Okay. As a stout man, then Omana se maven at the putte or the hade dade manusek, sweating with fear, the audio dog and buying veula veula falls to his harinang evake. I mean, the well built man connect him away in the bani. Neither. Yeah, if he is well built, he could have given a fight. Namut dadi veula no dadi vakirila veula nama. May velave ogulange manase putte me image ekak mavenawa. I know that. Sweating with fear, falls to his knees beneath a bough tree in a shower of sticks and stones. Mava gana daruwane. Polu muguru pihi kathi porowa aragena. Harida. Ara bogaha yata definitely maybe the maybe, okay, the bough tree of the peta, situated in peta, maybe. And also maybe it's in Borella, maybe. Kohe hari, boya dana gahasa wala pute, dahayak pahalavak, ekka manusse kuta, polumu guru walin pahara dena darshanaya. I know that that brutal incident, that brutal visual image comes to your mind. Definitely, that is the talent of the writer or the poet, right? Shop fronts in Peta, landmarks of our childhood, curls like old photographs. You have seen in that pictures that fires and burnings. Ara gini tiyana darshan api dakkane. Etore eva pute manas athule mavenawa apita. Blood on their khaki uniforms, three boys lie dying. Khaki uniforms lo le tavarela. Boys la tundenek marila. So that incident, that killing, that brutality, that violence, ill will and all. Mavila peena wane the uniform mandaga tundenek karavidiyata marila inno. Right. Those are the visual images. Number 8, irony and sarcasm. Right. Irony, I think you know what irony is. Irony is the expressing opposite of what is meant. Api balapurutu ena deeta vada padak opposite gana katha karanawa nan we call it as irony. You know that there are three types of irony, as verbal irony, situational irony and dramatic irony. Here most of the time you have verbal irony here. I'm stepping up my intake quite a bit. මේ දවස්වල මම අර හැමදාම යූෂුවලි ගන්න drink එක පොඩක් පොඩි ප්‍රමාණය වැඩි කරලා. That's all. අනේ වෙන කිසිම ගැටලුවක් නැහැ. මම පොඩක් drink එක පොඩක් වැඩි කරලා ගන්නවා. That is the only change we have these days. Obviously it is sarcastic. So that's why I have here put the irony and sarcasm together. We can't separate these things, right? It's ironical. It's not the thing he had to convey. Eka da puteyata kiyanna ona one attarama. Eka neme adahas kare. Me jeevithe tanikaram upside down vela. Topsy turvy vela. Confused vela. No any solace is there in any kind of moment. Eka tapparekata ahapiya wenna tarang sansun manasak solace ekak me minisunta naha putte. නමුත් ඒක අහනකොට කියන විදිහ නැතිං අනේ කිසි ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ කිසි අවුලක් නැහැ if I say in your language also පොඩක් අර අඩියක් ගත්ත එක දැන් ටිකක් අඩි එකහමාරක විතර වැඩි වෙලා that's only change I have I'm undergoing and here also your brave lands I sorry it should be brave lads ඔයාලගේ මේ එක තර්ක කරන්නත් පුළුවන් In the first print of the book, it was given as Your Brave Lands, right? I think in the later prints, it has given as Lads. That is okay. Lads, they are bravery. Right? We have seen in the pictures, how did these people, this young crowd, these hooligans, right? These rowdies celebrated the victory of massacring out those innocent Tamil people. Right? Etakota egolo brave, that is completely irony. and also sarcasm. අපි lands කියන එක ගත්තත් පුතේ කහරි දැන් land එක මෙයාලට අයිති නෑනේ. Right? This brave, this land does not belong to the Tamil people anymore. That's why these people were, people are killing those Tamil people. ඒක නිසානේ මරන්නේ. ඔය ඔය දෙපැත්තරම ගන්න පුළුවන් පුතේ. ඔගලගේ පොතේ බලන්න ඒක. It's a strange life we are leading here just now, not a dull moment. Again, he relates into that ironical idea. Oh, ටයක් අමුතු ජීවිතයක් නම් තමයි අමුතුයි කියන්නේ පුතේ තනිකරම අමුතුයිනේ. අමුතුයි නෙවෙයි. තප්පරෙන් තප්පරේ බය ගැහි ගැහි ජීවත් වෙන ලයිෆ් එකක් මේ. එතකොට කොහමද යා කියන්නේ not a dull moment කියලා. Dull? ඒ වර්ඩ් එක උනත් එතන පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ පුතේ in a quite ironical way. It's not dull actually. Dull නෙවෙයි මේක නේ. Boring නෙවෙයි. It's caring. හරිද? අර ඇඟේ මවිල් කෙලින් වෙනවා අඩි සද්ද ටිකක් ඇහෙනකොට පුතේ. අර තමිල් මෑන් අපිට කියනවනේ. When those torches come within the 50 feet. අර මේ ටෝච් අල්ලගෙන මහරෑ තිස්සේ ආවොත් it's not me. Sorry, it's not my books that go first by me. මගේ පොත් ටික නෙවෙයි ඉස්සල්ලාම යන්නේ මම යන්නේ. Right, so that එහෙමත් තියාගෙන දරුවනේ කියන්න පුළුවන් the not a dull moment කියලා. Actually, it is a really dull and scary and frightened and chaotic moment. අවුල් ජාලාවක් තියෙන්නේ. බඩගින්නට පුතේ කණ්ඩ බොණ්ඩ දෙයක් නැහැ. ගේ ඇතුලේ ජීවත් වෙන්න බයයි. සරණක් හොයාගෙන යන්න තැනක් නැහැ. පිහිටක් කියලා කාගෙන් ඉල්ලන්නද? අමු අමුයේ තමන්ගේ ඇස් ඉදිරිපිට තමන්ගේ දරුවෝ අඹු දරුවෝ මරණ හැටි බ්‍රූටල් කිලින් කියන හැටි බලාගෙන ඉන්නෝ. එහෙන් මෙහෙන් ඇහෙන්නේ ඊයේ අරගොල්ලන්ව මැරුවා අද මේගොල්ලන්ව මැරුවා කියන ස්කෑරි නිවුස් ටික විතරයි. In so in such a way can we argue that that will not a dull moment කියන ෆ්‍රේස් එක ගැන හිතන්න ඕන පුතේ. So that's why the writer used all these things in an ironical way. And also, they are really sarcastic. You know what sarcasm is? Pute dannawane sarcasm? In Sinhala, we call it upahasaya nirdayalasa. Right? Eka nikan aggressive form making tamai sarcasm yanne. They are pointing out in sarcasm, the writers point out weaknesses of humans, right? In a some kind of aggressive way. බිටවේ දරුණු ලෙස නිඳාවට පත් කරලා පොඩක් පහසයට දැඩි ලෙස නිර්දාය ලෙස හිත රිදෙන විදිහටම කියනවා පුතේ. හිත රිදෙනවනේ කරන්න දෙයක් නැහැ. ඊට වැඩිය රිදිලානේ තියෙන්නේ මේ මිනිස්සුන්ට. So the writer is really really capable in giving such kind of and using irony and sarcasm in the poem. Right. And also there are several points. The role of policeman. I showed you in the picture also, dear children. Hamma tanama wate piteema puthe me wage chaotic incident sidu weddi. Amu amuwe manushya gathana sidda weddi. So those people were gathering, they aren't talking with each other. So why do these people were wearing that kind of uniforms even? Is there any kind of validity of wearing such kind of a uniform, minisu uniform ekarane puthe garu karanne. So that uniform denotes all the law and order of the country. So if those people were blind to such situations, what is the fate of an innocent man? Me wage ahinsaka minisunge fate ekak gana katha karanna deyak naha ne puthe. Etore e minisu policeman kiyana word ekata sadharanada. No, that was the prevailing condition within that Black July. So you have to understand all these things. And the telephone conversation of the minority educated person, all are ironical and sarcastic. Right. Number 9. Understatement. Oh, litotis. So now you know what exaggeration is, right? Exaggeration කියන්නේ මොකක්ද කියලා ඔයාලා දන්නවනේ පුතේ. අපි අතිශයෝක්තිය කියලා කියනවා in සිංහල. That means making small things bigger. That is called exaggeration. But if the writer conceals the truth, or else if the writer hides the reality or the real situation by just giving only a very simple thing, පොඩි දෙයක් දීලා පුතේ ඇත්තම සිටුේෂන් එක නොකිය ඉන්නවා නම් that technique is called understatement or literatis, right? Here, now you see I'm stepping up my intake quite a bit. පුතේ මීට වඩා ගොඩක් තැන් තියෙනවා. I have taken only few points, right? මම ටිකක් වැඩි කරලා ගන්නවා කිව්වහම මේක නෙවෙයි ඇත්ත සිටුේෂන් එක හංගලා පුතේ කියන්නේ. Not a dull moment කියලා කියනකොට it's a strange life we are leading here just now කියනකොට ඒ ඇත්ත සිටුේෂන් එක නෙමෙයි අනේ නෑ දැන් අපෙන් අහන්නේ හරි දැන් if somebody from abroad ask how are you now ආශ්‍රේෂණ එකත් එක ගත්තොත් අපි ජීවත් වෙනවා that it's not the same happiness we gained at the previous days by going to school and having chats with the friends and learning and being with the teachers and all. That is not the normal situation. Still, even now here we are leading. එතන අපිටත් දැන් එපා වෙලා තියෙනවනේ නේද? නැතුව නෙවෙයිනේ. So then that is that concealing the truth කියන එක තියෙනවනේ. Concealing the real situation, that is called the understatement. Now here that quotation we have discussed. I think it is the last point of techniques. Auditory images and onomatopoeia. Auditory images, I think you know, that is the sound images. And onomatopoeia in the sense, what is it? I think, as I remember, I discussed with this, the Nightingale also. Onomatopoeia, kela kiyana puthe. The pronunciation gives the meaning. So clamoring, very hand in a telephone. That sound comes. Word ek pronounce karna kota api dano ek niyam bohoma loku sound ek me clamoring telephone. Non-stoply rings, right? Clamoring telephone. On a metaphoric venama wage ma pute ek sound ek normal landline ek ring vena sound ek api da ehe nama. Thama me manusya alive. Thama me lines cut pela nahe. Tama, still these things were working, right? Eva veda tama. Tama alive inne tama me avasanne tarawage hooligans la akramane karala naha nathi nisai. Natha ithin phone ekak ring wenawa ahandawat puluwanda? Etani mohwa gannawane. Namuth baya nathi bohoma niskalanke yawilla tamai ara receiver ekak ganne puthe. Calm hands quit the clamoring telephone. That's what the poet says, because now he has understood everything regarding the situation. He knows that I don't have any kind of escapism, right? Methaning mata escape wenna baha. That is the reality he has understood. So that's why he has sent Padmini and the girls to a neighboring house. Of course, yes. Right? ඒකනේ එයාගේ බිලවුඩ්ස් ලා ටික කොහෙට හරි යවලා මෙයා මේ සිටුේෂන් එකට බ්‍රේව්ලි ෆේස් කරන්නේ. එතකොට බ්‍රේව් ලෑඩ්ස් කියලා කියන්න ඕනේ මේ වගේ පුද්ගලින්ට නෙවෙයිද? Why not their children? So those are the techniques. Those are the basic techniques given in the poem. And I hope you all have understood these things with the evidences. And there's one more thing I want to discuss with you, dear children. That is, pute then koi velawata the techniques gana sandahan karanne. We have seen even in the paper marking that there are many more children. Whatever the question asked, they are just revealing techniques, themes and all. එහෙම අදාළ නැහැ පුතේ. If you are given a question like this, how does the poet deals with the theme of racial violence, ethnic violence in the poem Big Match 1983? You have to understand there are two parts of that kind of question. One is regarding the ethnic violence And the other one, how? කොහොමද deal වෙන්නේ කියලා අහන්නේ. They are in that type of question, dear children, you have to use this kind of techniques. With these techniques, that is how the poet or the poetess deals with that kind of theme. So you have to mention about, you have to describe the theme using some evidences. And then also you have to have evidences to prove the techniques used by the poet. So most of the time, dear children, our students do not attempt to their how part. Where how kiyana kotasata puthe ape daru attempt karanne naha. So then you will get half marks from out of 15. Bhagayak naha ne, neda. So then you have to have a thorough understanding about this. Okay. Past paper questions. That is basically, dear children, you have only one question so far. Up to now, since the beginning, from the 2016, this was not given as a critical question in your paper. There were reasons, but in this 2020, so I was just focused only on the past paper questions. But here, we see only this kind of big match question in 2020 paper, right? This is what the question. Discuss how a sense of social conflict is presented in the poem Big Match 1983. Shall I read it again? Discuss how a sense of social conflict is presented in the poem Big Match. Puthe metanat how kiyala ahanawa. If that how part is given, that question word how is given, you have to respond to the devices also. Sense of social conflict. Kohomada? Again, it goes back to the racial violence. Conflict ekak samaje athule sense of conflict kiyana de kohomada discuss karala tiyenne kiyala yahane. So these are several points. A conflict in both cities, Colombo and Jaffna, are presented. Api kiyuwane me deval mehe wenakota out of the Palmyra fences of Jaffna bristle 100 guns. Ehema neda api kiwwe. Ehemai poet apita kiwwe. So you have to deal with those and the nuances of the term big match. Though this is not the organization, remember that. I have just mentioned several points with the marking scheme also. So you can arrange in your according to your order and organization. That depends on you, no problem. The nuances of the term big match, definitely. From the title itself, the writer hints us this social conflict, right? ඔය තියෙන meanings තුනම ගැන පුතේ අපිට කතා කරන්න පුළුවන්නේ. Political and social factors which backed up the conflict. අපි දන්නවා ඒක අපිට second verse එක ඇතුලේ දුන්නා 1948. It was mentioned there. You know what had happened in the 1948. And then what else? 1956. Introduction of the Sinhala only bill. Rajya Bhashava Sinhala Bhasha Bata Patkiri Me Panata. Sinhala only bill was introduced. And in 1958, that is the first Sinhala and Tamil conflict over the issue of Sinhala being made the national language. So that was the first sparks, right? Which were hidden under the ashes. Came out. Apimayo sparks walata pute pavan gahala with this social landmarks. Apima tamayeva gini dalu bavata patkale. So you have to deal with that political factors and also the social factors along with them. That treacherous politics of language kena katha karapute. Treacherous politics of language. So all these. So all these things actually backed up the conflict. The political factors were the hidden hands behind the scene, right? ඔය සීන් එක පිටුපස්සේ තිබුණ invisible political hands, nothing else. So these blindly followed mobs and hooligans created the massacre, right? And then again, you can discuss, you have to deal with how innocent civilians become victims. That you can argue that the innocent children who were killed, right, in a very inhuman and callous way, who know nothing about these petty discriminations like class, creed, and race and all, may pute me discriminations gana kisima dayak nodanna ahinsaka daruwo podi daruwo the child lies dead kiyala kiwwe near the smashed bicycle, right? So they are really indifferent to these kind of discrimination prevailed in the society. Egolanta eva they don't know, and even they have no any heed attention regarding those, but that treacherous language of politics destroyed the innocent lives, right? You can trace such kind of evidence from the poem, and even the soldiers who tried to maintain the law and order, even the policemen, so they were also killed and they were dead, right? They had to have faced the death during that season, right? They were remained with fatal injuries and all. So these dead bodies of children definitely may belong to the minority community. So they were the Tamils. Maybe those the uniformed people who were killed, the three boys were belong to the Tamil ethnicity. So that's why maybe they were also killed. So then you can argue, and even you can take the image of stout man who were under the bow tree. So you can argue those people are really innocent, know nothing, right? Nothing have done, nothing had done to this kind of social conflict and all. And the violence was aimed at soldiers, businessmen, and even children. You can have the evidence. That is the part of social conflict, right? Eka puthe social conflict ekak gana kotasane. So then how do you respond to the part how? Discuss how? I told you. There you have to discuss about the collection of poetic devices. Puthe oya tiena collection ekak okkoma liyanna awashya ne. But you can select the most prominent and significant devices used in the poem, right? The use of irony and sarcasm to introduce the sense of violence. May violence ekak introduce karanna puthe pawichchi karala thiyena devices. And the metaphors, symbols, and understatement, right? Nuances. Api nuances gana kalin katha karana nisa kamak naha. So those things, at least within one paragraph or two, you have to. That is a must. You need to describe those kinds of poetic devices used in the poem. That is how, with these, with the use of these devices, the poet has the poet is able to discuss the social conflict in this Black July season, right? A social conflict tamai puthe discuss karanne with these collection of poetic devices. So that is how. And then you can have the last paragraph conclusion, right? Restating the points, yes. Restating the points given, you have mentioned in the body paragraphs, yes. Okay, I think that is how you have to organize this kind of answer. So this is the only question given so far from the 2016. Right, okay, dear children, I think that is what we have to discuss today. From here we finish the poem big batch, right? And then I think that is the I mean, this is the most lengthiest poem we have in our syllabus. I know that most of you are really ignoring the poem, but please don't do that. That is a very good poem, which you can have your own argument in it. Because we all are Sri Lankans, dear children, right? Api hamoma ekka wage. We are Sri Lankans. So that black mark belongs to all of us. Now we are going ahead. We are moving ahead with all these black marks from the history, right? So we can't avoid these things. So in a little and more way, we all had contributed. I mean, we as Sri Lankans have contributed for this kind of black stains, right? We can't avoid these. So it's really nice poem. In my point of view, I think you can have a very good argument with the questions. They are angata danenda liyanda puluwan kela kiyanne. That kind of poem is this, right? So then I think with these things, we come to the end for today. And there are a lot of students here. And thank you very much, dear children, for participating in this session. And your participation is really encouragement for us, right? I hope you had a good time with me. I think you gathered a lot with this session. And thank you very much, dear students. Thank you very much for joining. And dear sirs and madams, it's really nice of you for giving me the chance to deal with this kind of a lot of children. And thank you, dear children, and God bless you all.